All right, of course, with all this coronavirus talk, there's been a lot of misinformation and a lot of rumors floating around.
All right, so we asked Dr. Patrick Ludke from Lane County Public Health to kind of help us sort out the fact from all the fiction. So, Doctor, first of all, thank you very much. I know you're very, very busy. But let's start with the most basic question. Do you think, based on what Emma just said, do you think coronavirus will be in Lane County soon?
I think we have a very good chance of having cases, and it may be that we've already had an asymptomatic case or two come through our community, and that wasn't spread. So, yes, I think we're going to see some.
All right.
Do you think hospitals are prepared?
I do, and we're working very closely with them. I think the public health response is really robust and multi-layered, I would say. Working with hospitals, urgent care, schools, long-term care facilities, we're doing a lot.
How much does this scare you now that we know that you don't have to have been in China to contract this virus? It's just in the community now.
Well, I think that it's important to say that people should probably be attentive and not worried. This virus is nowhere near the level of death that we've seen in other viruses that are even related to this, like SARS and MERS. Middle Eastern Respiratory Syndrome is also a coronavirus. So we should be concerned, I think, and we should be attentive to what's going on, but I don't think this is anywhere near cause for panic.
What about vaccines? There's no vaccines yet, right?
There is not, and it's going to take some time. If you think about the process to make these products, you have to create a product that will allow your immune system to respond and make protective antibodies. Then you have to test it in people,
sure.
And we all have different chemistries, so you have to test it in a lot of people before you can get a good vaccine.
Is there a chance this could pass, that by summer it's just gone and we're not talking about it as much anymore?
You know, it's a coronavirus, and every year, 20 to 30% of all the colds that we experience are also coronaviruses, so they don't go away. They mutate a little bit, and next year it's a slightly different virus, but we still have coronaviruses. So I suspect this one will be around for some time.
We talked about masks earlier today and how somebody was at one of our newsroom employees was at Walgreens and they were gone, as they are pretty much anywhere, online, everywhere you cannot get masks. Should people be rushing to get one, or you said that most people don't even really know how to wear them right anyway?
Yeah, I don't think this is something that we should be promoting, and public health is not, and I'm hoping others are not as well, but people tend to use masks wrong. In the medical world, and surgeons and surgical staff, they use them correctly,
sure.
But many people overuse them. They use the same mask for days. If you think about every time you breathe on a mirror, it fogs up.
Mm-hmm.
Well, that's because you're breathing out some water vapor. That water vapor degrades the mask. So the masks are only good for a short period of time, and yet people reuse them and use them incorrectly. So it's not a safety measure that we're promoting.
You said you had 200 phone calls on your cell phone today.
I did.
What is the one thing people, probably in the public eye, and more so now that you're going to start getting a little bit more publicity, but what's the one thing that people are asking you or wanting an answer from you?
So about half of those calls are from the clinical community, and those are not calls of panic. Those are calls of how do we collaborate, how do we work together, what is the public health messaging on ABC, masks, public health messaging on getting the testing done at the state public health laboratory. And the other half are calls internally with other public health colleagues. So the key messages, I think, are number one, don't panic. Number two, all those things that mom told you to do, wash your hands, cover your cough and sneeze, exactly, and throw away soiled tissues, they are just as important with this virus as any other respiratorily spread virus.
All right.